according to the service manual on how to test the exciter coil, primary coil, and then the pickup coil, pulse generator, known as a pulser. Then the next one is the ignition coil, then the spark plug, including the TPS, a throttle position sensor, and our carburetor of our Honda CRF 2007 model, 2007 model 450X. So the exciter coil or primary coil. So there is the 6-wire from the stator of our Honda CRF 450X. First one, the exciter coil is black with stripe red. Then the other one is blue. There are two wires comes from the exciter coil of our stator of the Honda CRF 450X 2007 model. Okay, black, red, then blue. The service manual mentioned the 9 to 28 ohms. This is the minimum, 9 to 28 ohms. Then the pickup coil or pulse generator, known as a pulser, there are two wires, blue with yellow stripe, then green with white. So according to the service manual, 180 to 200 ohms. This is the disconnected the connection of the pickup coil or pulse generator, disconnected. So this peak voltage measure 0.7 volts. So disconnected wire while cranking the engine. So the minimum 0.7 volts. But as of now, there is no peak voltage adapter. So this is the one or measure. You get the resistance 180 to 200 ohms. Then the ignition coil, we want to do is primary and secondary. So primary 0.1 to 0.3 ohms, and the secondary, take note with spark plug cap, from 9 to 16 ohms. So the spark plug 5 to 15 the resistance reading. So in the TPS in our carburetor, so blue and black wire. So the resistance limit 4 to 6 ohms. This is the wire from the stator coil. So there are 6 wires. So yellow, white, this is to the our voltage regulator rectifier, the charging system, the charging coil supply, and then the light coil to the voltage regulator, and the headlight bulb to the headlight bulb. So this is black with red according to the service manual, This is the primary coil, exciter coil. Then the pure blow. This is the output of the winding, our exciter coil. So according to the service manual, 9 to 28 ohms, 200 ohms seating. So ohms checking, primary coil, exciter coil, resistance checking, positive probe, no problem, it can interchange, that is probe, either black probe or red probe. So observe 19.6. So it's good according to the service manual, 9 to 28. So 19.6, good. The exciter coil is good. The next force generator connection. So this service manual said 180 to 200 ohms. So 2k ohms. Topiums 247 kilohms, so above minimum. Then let's go to the ignition coil. Okay, the primary coil, primary 0.1 to 0.3 ohms. So 200 ohms. So primary ground probe to the ground. So 0.3 ohms. According to the service manual, 0.1 to 0.3 ohms. 0.3. That's good. The secondary, including the spare plug cap, secondary 9 to 16 k ohms. So 20k seating. So try. So there is a contact now. Thirteen point six nine seven. 14.3839. So according to the service manual, 9 to 16 ohms. So it's okay. Now let's go to the TPS, the throttle position sensor, our carburetor. So the service manual, 4 to 6 ohms, blue and black wire, 200 to 20 ohms. So there is a reading. Okay. 4.63. So according to the SIG manual, 4 to 60 ohms. This is good. So if there is abnormal reading, the motorcycle while reading the throttle, if there is a problem with RTPS, maybe the engine. So spark plug resistance, the service manual said 5k to 15k ohms. Setting. So no problem, it can be interchange. If there is a reading, meaning bad spark plug or the insulator may be broken. So observe. The tip of the spark plug. So five point something. So according to the service manual, 5k to 15k. So it's okay. That's good, because this is the priest spark plug, very new. Oh, it's okay. Thank you for watching.